And today we will be dwelling on the topic, is diabetes a coronary artery disease equivalent? If I have to express my topic in mathematical equation form, it would look like this one. Whether cardiovascular risk in diabetics who don't have any established coronary artery disease, is it equal to a patient who has coronary artery disease with no diabetes? So meaning thereby, shall we treat all patients of diabetes as aggressively for coronary artery disease, for future events of coronary artery disease, just as we treat our patients of established CAD? Well, diabetes affects how they all collectively produce subclinical atherosclerosis. And as the disease progresses over a period of time in 10, 15 or 20 years, they develop atherosclerotic clinical events in the form of stable angina, unstable angina, myocardial infarction and heart failure and even death. Well, this concept of treating diabetics equivalent to established coronary artery disease patients, it came into vogue once Hefner study was published in 1998. This Hefner study has an interesting background. Well, Hefner was the star investigator. He was the lead investigator. Just like we have star investigators in hypertension, we have Salim Yusuf and there are many other people who are celebrity in their own right. Well, this Hefner study was done in Finland. The subjects or the patients were Finnish. Other authors of the article were Finnish. Leading other investigators were Finnish. And the study was done in Finnish people. It was done in two parts of Finland. Well, one was Turku, which is in the southwest of Finland. And another was in the University of Kuopio, which is in northeast of Finland, which is actually the center of Finland. And why these two regions were selected? Because in Finland, Turku has the least incidence of coronary artery disease, while Kuopio has the highest incidence of coronary artery disease, in spite of being just 450 kilometers apart from each other. And this was the result of Hefner study. Well, this is also known as East-West study because it was the Kuopio region is in the east and Turku is in the west of Finland. It is also known as the East-West study. And this is the iconic slide of Hefner's research. Well, subjects were divided into four groups. First group is depicted by this green line, that 98% of people were alive at the end of 8 years who did not have any CAD and no diabetes at all. While this blue line depicts people who had diabetes and who had suffered at least one episode of myocardial infarction. They had a step ladder, progressively downhill course of survival. So least survival was seen after 8 years in those people who had diabetes and who had suffered at least one myocardial infarction. Our area of interest is this yellow and red line. This yellow line is of diabetic subjects who did not have any previous MI, and red line is of non-diabetic subjects with previous MI, and they are closely following each other. This is the crux of Hefner study and this is the topic of discussion. This Hefner study told us that probably coronary artery disease and diabetes both are equivalent with each other. Both have same risk factor as shown in the survival rate. The risk factors that we all know, that obesity, smoking, dyslipidemia, hypertension, etc., etc. Well, American College of Cardiology has taken note of this Hefner study and other studies and written a paper on it. Well, American College of Cardiology website and review done 10 months back says that in 1998, Hefner reported that adults with diabetes had the same risk for future MI as adults with previous MI but no diabetes. Consequently, in 2001, National Cholesterol Education Program Adult Treatment Panel 3 guidelines, because of this Hefner study, they recommended that all individuals with diabetes be considered as coronary heart disease equivalent. It means that if a patient comes to you and says, "Doctor, yesterday I got my blood sugar test done and my blood sugar fasting and PP is high, and I also have glycosylated hemoglobin which is high, probably I am having diabetes for the last more than 3 months. Shall we write statin and aspirin to that patient also?" This is the implication of treating coronary artery disease and diabetes. American College of Cardiology, well, it says that these guidelines for diabetes as CAD equivalence was based on the premise that mortality in MI in diabetics is double of non-diabetics. Not only that, in post-MI patients also, follow-up mortality of diabetics is double of non-diabetics. American College of Cardiology has taken note of a recent, very important study. This study is known as Kaiser Permanente North California study. The beauty of this KPNC study is as compared to Hefner study in which subjects will all finish. And the results of Kaiser Permanente North California study was that as compared to individuals with no diabetes and no coronary artery disease, prevalent diabetes was associated with double the risk, but prevalent coronary artery disease was associated with triple the risk of coronary heart disease events. This means that yes, diabetes is a risk factor for future MI, for future heart failure, for future unstable angina, but pre-existing coronary artery disease is a bigger risk factor. Both are not equivalent. Prevalent CAD is more risky as compared to diabetes. Well, why differing results in Hefner and KPNC study? American College of Cardiology concludes that these findings differ substantially from the influential findings in the original Hefner study, possibly due to greatly intensified primary prevention efforts to reduce the risk of coronary heart disease in individuals with diabetes in the last 15 years. Hefner study was started in 1990, it was concluded and published in 1998, while KPNC study was published only last year. So there was a gap of 15 years, and in the last 15 years we have better diabetes medicine, patients are more aware about controlling diabetes, as physicians we are also aggressive in controlling the risk factors, and that is why probably in 1990 it was a CAD equivalent, presently it is not a CAD equivalent but at a slightly lower pedestal. This is also an interesting systematic review and meta-analysis. The important thing in this system is, well, duration of diabetes is also very important. British Regional Heart Study, well, this study told us that early onset diabetes is a risk factor similar to men who have previous MI. So, early onset diabetes is equivalent to coronary artery disease, but late onset diabetes is not equivalent to past MI, or it is not a CAD equivalence. Early onset diabetes means a person developing diabetes at an age of 25, 30 or 35 years of age group, while late onset diabetes means a person developing diabetes at 55, 60 or 65 years of age group. Individuals developing diabetes later in life might be less insulin resistant and have a better beta cell function. 10-year coronary heart disease risk for newly diagnosed diabetics may not be as high, but people with history of diabetes who have duration. Well, from every, in any conference, any CME you go, Framingham Heart Study is quoted. It is a very respectable study. The beauty of Framingham Heart Study is that it was started in 1948, when probably many of us were not even born at that point of time. Each and every person who is a resident of Framingham, Massachusetts, America, has a computerized record. Each and every health event is recorded of every person of Framingham. Third generation is being followed up, and that is the beauty. There is no other study which is being followed since 1948. And this Framingham Heart Study tells us that diabetic women, as compared to diabetic men, they are more prone to total CVD events, coronary heart disease, cardiac failure, and intermittent claudication. The only thing in diabetic men which is higher as compared to diabetic women is cerebrovascular accidents. So gender is also important as far as CAD and diabetes equivalence is concerned. Not only that, if a diabetic man suffers from MI and a diabetic woman suffers from MI, there are chances the diabetic woman will die early. So, in a diabetic woman, post points are concerned. We have till now talked about hyperglycemia producing CHD events. Let us talk about hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemia through blood coagulation abnormalities, through inflammation, through endothelial dysfunction, and through sympathoadrenal response produces CAD and affects the heart. Whenever there is hypoglycemic episode, there is release of adrenaline and noradrenaline, thereby making a person prone to cardiac arrhythmia and sudden cardiac death. The problem with hypoglycemia is that if patient can afford, then go for coronary artery calcium scoring. If CAC is high, then give statin and aspirin. And if CAC score is less, then there is no need to give statin and aspirin. Well, this is a cardiac CT of a patient showing coronary artery calcium deposition. American College of Cardiology concludes that not all patients with diabetes are coronary heart disease equivalents. It may be prudent to consider entire risk factor profile rather than merely the presence of diabetes. Diabetes in general should be viewed as a high risk state, no doubt about it. Well, that was the theoretical discussion as far as the equivalence of diabetes and CAD is concerned. However, whether we should start aspirin and statin in patients of diabetes, what is the current recommendation of international bodies? Well, this is not automatically equivalent to having experienced MI and thus does not warrant aggressive pharmacotherapy. Cardiovascular risk should be protected and therapy guided by taking into account individual risk factors. But what about the treatment part? It says that not merely the presence of diabetes, but diabetes plus one or more risk factor. If that is present, then statin and aspirin should be started. And what is that one more risk factor? Age is more. So, just like a second class general compartment of Indian Railways, people squeeze in through windows. Same is the case with drug therapy. More and more medicines are squeezing into just like general compartment of second class of Indian Railways. We have to write 5 medicines for treatment of diabetes. Now we have to add statin, we have to add aspirin, we have to give vitamins, we have to treat hypertension, so on so forth. So our prescription is becoming longer and longer. So conclusion is, that concept of diabetes as a CAD equivalent postulates that patients with diabetes who do not yet have CAD are at an equally high CAD risk as non-diabetic patients with CAD. This implies important therapeutic, psychological, and economic consequences to the patient. Whereas several reports support the concept of diabetes as CHD risk equivalent, others refute it. Not all patients with diabetes are at the same CV risk. Cardiovascular disease risk conferred by diabetes is strongly modulated by gender, duration of diabetes, concomitant risk factors, and the presence or absence of subclinical atherosclerosis. Ladies and gentlemen, don't be afraid of bull, that is diabetes. Tame the bull by proper control of diabetes. And just like most conflicts can be resolved over drinks, if you don't agree with any part of this presentation, we can resolve it over drinks. Thank you so much. Any query?
How to measure coronary artery calcium?
Well, coronary artery calcium can be measured by asking all CT, any of the CT centers to go for cardiac CT. But problem is that cost varies anywhere from 4,000 to 7,000 rupees in Delhi. Well, Mukul Radiology Center of Malviya Nagar is doing at 4,000 rupees. Sanya Imaging of First Class is doing at 6,000 rupees. Mahajan Imaging is doing at 7,000 rupees. So shall we conclude this session and continue with our drinks? All conflicts are resolved. Thank you so much.